So renewable energy is changing a lot of things about the power grid. You think about the old grid as a group of rotating gears that are all synchronized. The new grid is replacing many of those gears with computer-controlled sources. And so you're ending up with a grid that is basically a bunch of synchronized computers controlling the stability of the power system. So that can cause things like instability, like the grid voltage and frequency can all start to oscillate and shake around, which is a major stability concern for the power system. You can also have things like wind and solar all suddenly turning off because of a disturbance on the grid. So my work and the work of the people that I team with is focused on giving utility engineers the tools they need to operate a grid with really high levels of wind, solar, and battery without needing to worry about these stability issues. We've seen some events in California and in Texas that have gotten a lot of press where hundreds of megawatts and sometimes even gigawatts of wind and solar have tripped off instantaneously in response to a relatively minor grid event. And so this has caused a lot of research to try and make sure that things don't happen again. The other thing that we've seen that's even more interesting is on the island of Kauai, where they have lots of battery and solar plants, is that their largest synchronous generator, which was 60% of the generation, tripped offline instantaneously. Normally the grid wouldn't be able to survive an event like that. The solar and battery plants almost instantaneously ramped up their power to save the grid and kept the grid online, which is pretty awesome. But for the next minute after that, the grid oscillated 18 to 20 times per second, and the oscillation eventually went away, but it indicated a major stability problem on the power system. So to help the utility investigate what happened there and try to understand it, the first thing we did, we just got really detailed waveform level data of what happened at all the different sites on the island to see what were they doing during that event. And then we also took their model, which was designed for sort of the old grid with lots of synchronous machines, and updated it to an electromagnetic transient model, which is a model that models the actual waveforms of the power system. It's a lot more detail and it runs a lot more slowly. It could take hours to run an event that lasts a couple of seconds, but it can give you all the detail of what happened in that event. If you have good models of the solar plants and the battery plants and the rest of the grid, you can fully understand what's happening on that grid. And so we built up that model, validated it against the field data from that event, and then used that to understand what could we do so that you could still save the grid, but not cause this oscillation. And we proposed three different ways of mitigating those. We then took those and actually tested them in our lab, where we have an actual megawatt scale hardware inverter that's the same as one of the inverters that's out on that island, connected it up to a model of the Kauai power system, and tested the mitigation methods that we proposed. And the utility actually implemented one of those on the island, which was converting one of those inverters to a grid-forming inverter, which is an inverter that doesn't try to measure voltage and frequency and respond to it, but rather just tries to hold its own voltage and frequency constant. An interesting thing that then happened in April of this year was that the same plant tripped offline. The PV and battery plants, again, ramped up their power almost instantaneously and saved the grid, and they didn't cause this oscillation because one of them had been converted to grid-forming mode. This is important to achieving our clean energy goals because currently some utilities around the world are already putting limits on how much wind and solar and battery they can have online at any given moment because of these stability concerns. So basically we're trying to remove that barrier and let the grid continue to move to even higher levels of renewable energy while maintaining stability.